/scoreboard. In this video, you'll learn all about Minecraft scoreboards. Minecraft scoreboards might just be the most bizarre way of storing information that has ever been conceived. For many, the word scoreboard evokes images of the sidebar on Hypixel, constantly reminding you that you are, in fact, playing on Hypixel. Some may know that in plain old vanilla Minecraft, scoreboards have something to do with storing numbers. It can be hard to wrap your head around. Mojang seems to have created them with the intent to create the most confusing and obtuse way of dealing with information in Minecraft. In this video, I will unravel the idiosyncrasies of Minecraft scoreboards and help you on your way to becoming the Minecraft god you've always been meant to be. Let's start with what scoreboards are good at: tracking built-in Minecraft statistics. There's a couple terms we'll need to familiarize. There's a couple terms we'll need to familiarize ourselves with if we want the rest of this video to make any sense at all. So let's get those out of the way. The scoreboard command deals with lists of players, like, well, a scoreboard. Each player on the scoreboard has a number associated with them. That's the score part. These lists of players and scores are called objectives. Because, computer science, I'm not really sure about the etymology of the word objectives, but that's what these lists are called, and it's very important you remember that. The actual score that a player has is determined by the criteria of the objective. Simply put, a criteria is anything you can find on the statistics page, plus a couple of extra things. Tracking these built-in criteria is really where scoreboards shine and work smoothly. The further we stray from this, the further we stray from sanity. And if you're liking this tutorial so far, make sure to subscribe. It gives me the validation that I need to keep sitting in front of a computer explaining my in-depth knowledge of Minecraft commands to strangers online. So let's see how to create our first scoreboard objective. It's real easy. /scoreboard, then we get two options, objectives or players. We want to add an objective, so we do scoreboard objectives add, and let's make this a death counter. First, we put the name, deaths, where it says objective, and then we put the criteria. So right up here, we got death count. Let's choose death count, and you can pick a display name that takes JSON format like Telraw, and that'll show up here on the sidebar whenever the name is visible. Deaths is a fine name. I'll capitalize the D at least. Okay, created a new objective, deaths. Okay, cool. Now a scoreboard objective exists somewhere out in the void. To see our nice new objective, we need to do scoreboard objectives set display. There are three options for where our scoreboard can be displayed. Sidebar is this thing. It's nice because it's sorted. The player with the highest score is shown on top, and then it goes down. This is good for scores in minigames, or maybe a kill count. I would avoid using it outside of a temporary minigame because it can take up a lot of room on the screen for some people, and it can get in the way, especially when it has a lot of players or players with super long names. List is referring to the list of players in the tab menu. Finally, below name will show up, well, below your username. This is often used for health bars in PvP minigames, or death counts in SMP. Let's set our death count to appear in the tab list. So scoreboard, objectives, set display, list, and then we pick which one we want. I want deaths to appear in the tab list. And there it is, we've got zero deaths. If I die, I have one death. Amazing. An important thing I realized I almost forgot to mention is how to get rid of them. Let's say we want to clear out this example sidebar. All you have to do is scoreboard objective set display sidebar, and that will just make it disappear. Also, I did say that there were three, but you may notice that this is a lot more than three options. That's because the sidebar can be set to only appear for a specific color team. So, if I ever make a teams tutorial, I'll be sure to cover that. If you're not working with teams, you don't need to worry about that stuff. Let's also add a player kill count, in case some of you are making a PvP minigame. Scoreboard objectives add, and we'll call this one kills. Then we pick player kill count as our criteria. Add that, and then set it to appear on the sidebar with scoreboard objectives set display sidebar kills. And there it is. Oh, wait. No, it isn't. Why isn't it on the sidebar? Because I don't have any kills. And if nobody has a score, the sidebar will not appear. But once I or somebody else gets a kill, it will appear. This gonna work? No. This is so sad. That doesn't count as a kill. All right, we don't have to include that in the video then. Let's manually add a kill to my score so that we can see it show up. Scoreboard players is the beginning of the command for anything you want to do that will change the score. Then we do our player, I'll do at S, that's me, the player running the command, and then kills, capital K, I'm gonna add a score of 1. And there I am, added 1 kill for Legitimoose, now 1. Let's add 10. Let's add 1 billion. Amazing. But I would like to point out that we can also just set a score. So we can just set my score to 0 in case we need to do such a thing. And if we want it to disappear entirely, we can use reset. Amazing! There is going to be a part 2 of this video where I talk about the scoreboard operation command. It's super useful. It's like math stuff, you know? If you want to see that, the link will be here as soon as it's released. So make sure to subscribe because there's a pop quiz on this whole thing in 3 days, and if you fail it, you're not going to graduate. Legitimoose out, 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 out.